I'm here with Ronnie Shields, one of the best trainers in boxing, and I caught up with him about his fighter, Erslandy Lara. Check it out. So, Ronnie, you're a real hands-on coach. You do everything.
Of course, man. That's my job.
Well, why do you love boxing so much? Because I see you in the smaller shows with the fighters that are just starting. I see you in the major shows like this weekend in L.A. A week later, you're here with Erslandy Lara. You love it.
I love it because, you know, I mean, this is what I grew up in, you know. People are trying to downgrade the sport, and I'm not going to let that happen, you know. I don't, you know, whether you're a small guy, you're a big guy, it don't make a difference, you know. Whether you 1-0 or 0-10, it don't make a difference. You know, you could be 50-0, it don't make a difference, you know. If I feel you have potential, I'm going to work with you. That's who I am. That's the way I am.
Even though you train very talented fighters and they have amazing records, you personally don't get always the recognition that some other trainers get when they talk about the bet. Why is that, do you think? I mean, the proof is you train guys and they do well.
Well, you know what? That's not for me to worry about, you know. I just do my job. My job is to train fighters, you know. My job is I'm on the outside. I'm not on the inside with this thing, you know. I mean, you know, people see, they recognize, hey, you know, if you recognize it or not, it don't make a difference to me, you know. I'm still going to do it. It's not going to make me stop doing what I'm doing, you know. And, you know, I get calls all the time. I don't take every fighter because I don't have the time to take every fighter. But I get calls from a lot of big guys, too, not just the smaller guys that people don't hear about. But, you know, I'd rather work with somebody who I feel I can get along with, who I know I can work with, you know. Hey, and, you know, if we turn out champions, that's fine.
We have a young gentleman over here, Erslandy Lara, extremely talented. I just saw he looks like he became much stronger now since his last one because he's been working out well. Tell me about that, his improvement.
Well, you know, we're sitting down more on punches now. You know, this is why you're going to see a lot more knockouts because he is sitting down more on his punches. I'm not changing anything else from him, you know, but every now and then you go see him sit down, and we're sitting down. Trust me, none but all power coming. And, you know, and it's proof in the pudding. Look at, you know, of his last 7 fights, 6 been first round knockouts. So it's proofing all the time.
There's talk that he may be the next opponent for Canelo Alvarez. I know we don't want to jump the gun because you have your big fight right here, but well, is that something that you guys would want if it came up?
All it is talk, okay? That's all. Nothing more than talk. You know, and there's people on our side that's talking, not the people that count is talking. So it doesn't make a difference what we think or what we say. You know, it's not going to happen. That's just simple as that. You know, they're not going to put Canelo and Lara at this moment. You know, sooner or later it's going to have to happen. But look, our job is to just keep doing what we've been doing, and that's winning, and winning impressively. And then sooner or later, that demand is going to happen. It's going to come. So, but if it don't happen this fight, we're not worrying about it, you know. We have a Freddy Hernandez to think about on Saturday night.
Tough,
that's all we're thinking
tough
about.
Tough opponent.
Absolutely.
How are you
Absolutely.
Guys gonna beat him or stop him?
Hey, you know, our job is just to go in there and do our business, you know, and to look good doing it and to show the skills that Erslandy Lara has. And, you know, that's all we go do. You know, we're not worried about whether we knock him out, we go to a decision. The most important thing is him being impressive, the way he's always been impressive in every fight. So that's all that matters. Nothing else matters.
I noticed when you do a mitz with him, sometimes you give instruction in English, sometimes you give him in Spanish, and he understands both. So
yes.
I see I'm impressed with your Spanish.
Well, you know, I'm just trying to, you know, we talk to him in English also to try to get him a better understanding. And it's coming, you know, it's coming slowly but surely. But look, we have no problems in the gym with talking to each other.
You said they understand.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, what should people know about Erslandy Lara? Because we just know the boxer. You know him as a human being. What can you share with them?
He's a great family man. You see, he's got his wife with him. You know, they got 2 kids together. And, you know, he's a family guy, you know. And he moved to Houston so we could, you know, have more time to work with each other. So, you know, that lets you know he's dedicated to the sport of boxing. And, you know, he was in Miami at first, and, you know, he said, you know what, I got to be where my trainer is. So he moved to Houston.
How far do you see him going in the sport now that he's with you and you're working together?
Well, I think sky's the limit, you know, as far as, you know, look, we feel he could beat anybody. We've been challenging people, but, of course, we have to fight out of our weight. We're probably the only guy right now who has to fight out of his weight in order to get a fight. You know, and it's crazy. Now we finally found somebody who's moved up in weight, who's willing to take the challenge, and that's Freddy Hernandez, who's a very good fighter. You know, so, you know, we just got to keep, you know, when they put him in, we got to knock him down. And, you know, and then keep on going. And then sooner or later, not only the public are demanding, but television will have to start saying, you know what, you know, this kid deserves a chance. You know, he deserves a shot at the big time. So sooner or later, it's going to happen. When it happened with Paul Williams, everybody saw, you know, everybody saw, even the TV saw. But you know what? They didn't fight for him to come back with a rematch or anything else, and it didn't happen. So, you know, until he become a household name, you know, then sooner or later, you know, that's going to happen real soon, I believe.
What's your philosophy as a trainer when a kid comes to you? Are you very strict? Are you very lenient? Is it somewhere in the middle?
Well, I think it's more of in the middle with me. You know, I like to get along with the fighter first. I like to let him know that, you know, my job is to train him hard. I'm not his friend. You know, I'm not the friend at all. I could be the friend outside of boxing, but I can't be the friend inside of boxing. You know, because then he won't respect me, and I won't probably won't have no respect for him. So, you know, it's all about keeping the respect level going. And I hardly ever hang out with any of my fighters, you know. But we do have a relationship in the gym. And with me being the teacher and they being the student. And it's always worked for me. I've never had a problem with a guy. So, you know, I just want to keep it going that way.
Any message to your fans or Zlandi Lara fans if they're watching right now?
Hey, tune in on Showtime on Saturday night because, you know, Lara's going to put on another stellar performance.
There you have it. Ronnie Shields, one of the best in the business. Look out for him, of course, there's Zlandi Lara. He is reporting.com. And Mike's back reporting.